when you smell the odor of freshly rolled over skunk on the road, I always think it smells like a roasted coffee bean. And at the beginning, I would be like all the other people, like, oh my God, that's an ugly smell. But then with the second thought, I'm like, I like it because it smells like roasted coffee bean. The Morocco I knew very well was a Morocco from the beginning of the 80s. So it was not as advanced as it is now. So there was a lot of smell, especially when you would go to the butcher. So for example, to me, the smell of blood would be a mix between a smell of rose and a smell also of cedar wood, because they are using like the cedar wood dust to drink the blood, for example, on the floor. So yeah, so voilà. Or for example, all the leather there back then, they were not treated, so they would not have an odor, so they were very smelly. When you would take a book cover, it would literally smell of goats, and I'm not exaggerating, for years. So all this, like, we had that in the house, so I'm not disgusted by this kind of smell. And in perfumery also, it's very interesting to put a little tiny bit of those nasty smell into your composition, because it's included already in nature. If you're thinking about the most beautiful flower and most expensive flower, like the jasmine, the tuberose, the orange flower, the gardenia, they all have this animalic smell. And that's what is giving the beauty and the particularity to this family of flowers. It starts with a vision, actually. Through a vision, you're gonna see like different texture, you're gonna see the colors, you can even perceive a mood when you see an image, to get inspired when you envision something. And if somebody is telling you, oh, you need to work on something pink, velvety, with a particular light, it's not the same than pink, silky, and another kind of light. So yes, it's like I'm painting olfactively. I love photography, so very often I do parallel with how you build up an image. So to me, when you start with an accord, you start around a raw material, and then you combine it with something that's gonna make it work, and this is like your subject when you come up with a strong accord. And then you will feel the rest of your formula. And then you need to play with light, to create contrast. So you need to find ingredients that are gonna be like your shadows. You're gonna have to work on what I call like the depth of field. It will be like the long lastingness of your fragrance, the strength that's gonna emanate of this image. It's gonna be like the diffusivity part of the fragrance. And you need to choose a particular angle. For example, if you're working on a rose, so sometimes you hear a customer who say, oh, no, we don't want to do like another rose. But no, there's like thousands of ways to make different roses. The same way you photography Kate Moss thousands of times, you will reinvent Kate Moss all the time. It will depend on the angle you choose, but it's the same in perfumery. What I love a lot about perfumery is the infinity of possibilities that you have to reach harmony, because at the end you still need to reach harmony without talking about beauty. Yeah.